Are you a fan of Jonathan Banks?
Dude, I'm probably the biggest fan.
Why?
Why? I've been boxing since I was 15.
You're kidding?
Yeah, then I hurt my shoulder. They just did a clip of that.
Of what? Of you getting injured?
I hurt my shoulder and I started training in the gym.
Are you a boxer?
I was.
Wow.
I was.
Wow. What's your name?
Minette.
You know he's one of the best heavyweights in the world today.
I know. That's why I was like.
Who do you want to see him fight?
With who?
Yes. Do you want to see him fight Chris Arreola? Do you want to see him fight Vladimir Klitschko?
Klitschko.
He's training Vladimir too. Besides being a fighter, he's also.
So it would be easier for him to know.
Yeah. Smart lady.
You know how he's fighting,
smart,
right?
That's
you
smart.
Know how he's
he has advantage. So what would you tell people about Jonathan Banks?
I mean, what I have seen from TV or your fight, great fighter. You read your fighters easy. You know what they're gonna come with next thing, hit you with. So I mean, this is a routinate guy. I mean, you can get anything better.
Wow. Thank you very
Good luck,
much.
Man.
That was very nice of you to say.
I can come and see your fight next time and
I hope
cheer
so
you.
Too. That'd be good.
Right. And you'll be at my show when I'm competing and cheer me.
Oh, when you compete in Germany?
No, I'm going to compete here, but I'm going to do a figure show.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
I have switched totally from boxing.
Oh, okay.
But
okay.
I'm watching every game. Okay.
Are you German?
No, from Sweden, but I'm Persian.
Sweden. Yeah. I love Sweden.
Yeah,
Stockholm. I went to Stockholm.
You'll be fighting there?
No, I didn't fight in Stockholm, but I went to Stockholm.
Yeah,
it's very beautiful.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. There you go. Jonathan Banks got fans everywhere. She's Persian from Stockholm, who's going to compete in Germany, and she follows your career. What do you say about that?
Hey, man, it's all good, man. I can't come. I got nothing bad to say about it. It's a good thing.
She got all excited, pictures and everything.
Yeah, I thought she knew who you was.
I thought
it was you.
You have a picture with Ellie Sutback.
No, not me. But let me ask you guys about this. What do you guys say about Gennady Golovkin? How exciting is that fighter?
No, he's a great fighter. I mean, Jonathan was up at the training camp in Big Bear. So, you know, kind of how Abel does a lot of his training with Gennady. And, you know, he's one of the most talented guys I've ever worked with in terms of just his drive, his ambition, his determination. And he's just waiting for the opportunity to show that he's the best middleweight in the world.
Gennady Golovkin is a, he's really a light heavyweight, but he's inside of a middleweight's body. So just keep that in mind. So when he punches you, you don't feel like you're being punched by a middleweight. I feel like you've been punched by a light heavyweight or something. So Gennady Golovkin really is 200 pounds, but he fight at 160. When you walk in the ring, he probably be 160. But in like his heart, he got like a 200 pound heart. Dude is talented though, man. All kidding aside, he's a very calm. He's calm. He's easy going, but he's willing to do whatever he got to do to win. And he's a big puncher, and that's what makes the fight exciting. Not only his style is different, he got a good style, but not only that though, his punching power can turn around anything. Like his last fight, the fighter, he was
Gabriel Rosado.
Gabriel Rosado had a little bit better feet work. His footwork was better than Golovkin's. But Golovkin just wore him down so bad. But his punching power, every time he punched him, he just took some steam out of him. You know, and if he didn't have that punching power, I think the dude would have ran circles around him and probably would have got a split decision out of him. You know, but Golovkin, you've seen him. He never panicked. He never got away from his game plan. He stuck with the game plan that Abel set for him. And I think him and Abel is a really, really good combination. And he showed a lot. He showed he had a lot more skill than power in that particular fight. That's why I like the fight so much. He showed more skill than power. Usually he shows little skill. He hit the guy, they fall, that's it. He showed more skill in the last fight, and that's what I really liked about the fight.
Tom, what's next for Gennady Golovkin?
Guy's gonna fight March 30th in Monte Carlo. He fought January 19th in Madison Square Garden, so that was one of the steps towards accomplishing his dreams over here in America. After these last two fights on HBO, he's really blown up over here in the States. He's become one of the most talked about fighters. Not for the fights that he has, but also for the fighters that are avoiding fighting him. So I think, like Jonathan said, it's just dealing with his punching power. You know, we need to get sparring partners that aren't even close to middleweights, you know, to spar with him. So the Monte Carlo fights against Ishida. Ishida has a lot of courage. You know, he fought James Kirkland, knocked him out in the first round.
Tough guy,
yeah. He's never been stopped. His last two losses were to Paul Williams and Pirog, you know, two great fighters. And so it'll be a good test for Gennady, and we expect good things for him. And then the next fight over here in the States, if everything goes the right way against Ishida, will be in June on HBO.
When I go from gym to gym and I ask people who are your favorite fighters, Gennady Golovkin is always among the top 3-4 names. When people tell me we like Mayweather, we like Pacquiao, we like, you know, Canelo, we like Gennady.
Well, he's got the unique quality of being a real humble and likable guy outside the ring, and that's what really attracts a lot of fans to him. Then also his style, his boxing style, being so aggressive, being able to cut off the ring, and his punching power. You know, he has the equalizers in his hands, and that's what really excites people, is just watching him get knockouts. I think that he's going on a 12 knockout streak right now, and he has the highest knockout percentage of any active champion. So that's it's a great motivation to work with him.
Did you see him when he trained his sparring partners? They all wear body protectors so they don't get hurt.
I've seen them.
Do you ever see that in training? I've never seen that.
I've seen him on some of his sparring partners, but I haven't seen them. I haven't seen that. No.
That's different.
No, it's different because I mean you're dealing with a guy who, I mean, in my opinion, he's just gifted with a punching power. You know, but the thing about it, what I like about Golovkin is the average fighter that's gifted with punching power relies on that punching power, and that's it. You know, but he's not relying on that. He's trying to develop his skill so he can have something to go with his punching power. And I think that's what separates Golovkin. And I think that's one of the reasons now he's slowly but surely becoming a household name. And people can adapt to him. You know, he got punching power. He don't rely on it. You know, he knows how to. You can see his skills when he fights. And I think that's going to bring him together as an all-around good fighter.
I think some of Vladimir's sparring partners might not object to the.
I know a lot of Vladimir's sparring partners that will not object to wearing some type of body protection because he hurts a lot of guys. I mean, it's not good. But
it's just with the Golovkin's guys. I mean, Vladimir gets so many guys. He gets like 6 or 7 guys at a time, just so, you know, because he's pretty hard on his sparring partners. But with Golovkin's guys, if you get anyone that's close to his weight, you really have to, you know, just so they can last through the training camp, have to give them some type of protection, you know, as far as with their body shots.
There you have it. Tom Loeffler, Jonathan Banks talking about Gennady Golovkin. Look out for him. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Mike Sackback reporting. Take a step back. Back.